Lesson 3, User Interface. The Autodesk Fabrication CamDuct user interface is very similar to that of Autodesk Fabrication ESTMAP. It's also similar to that of other Autodesk products such as AutoCAD in that it uses pull-down menus, toolbars, palettes, and right-click menus. But it uses a CAD engine that is somewhat different from the AutoCAD user interface. AutoCAD users will see strong similarities in the Fabrication CamDuct user interface, but anyone with some basic CAD experience can quickly learn this software. For this lesson, you'll do the following. Understand the various Fabrication CamDuct user interface components. Explore the pull-down menus. Review the utility bar commands. Examine the job contents window. Learn about the items folders window. Explore the quick takeoff window and toolbars. Learn about right-click shortcut menus. Exercise 1, User Interface Overview. Start Fabrication CamDuct. With the Imperial Content configuration highlighted, select Open Job. The Open Job window appears. Browse to the Exercise folder and select UserInterface.maj. Click OK. Fabrication CamDuct opens with a job that contains sheet metal ductwork items. Along the top of the program window are pull-down menus. Below the pull-down menus is the utility bar. This resembles a ribbon used in other Autodesk products and can be easily customized. Below the utility bar is the primary view pane of the program window. This view pane currently displays the job contents window, but it can also display the item folders window, the quick takeoff window, and or other windows. One or more of these windows could be displayed individually or as tiled or cascaded windows. Buttons on the utility bar can display some of the windows in the view pane. These buttons activate each window. The job contents window should be displayed. To verify this, select job contents on the utility bar. This is a tabular listing of all items in this job. This view may be customized. Click the Item Folders button on the utility bar. The Item Folders window appears and shows a tree view of the database. Expand the Imperial Content folder by clicking on the plus symbol that precedes the folder name. Expand the Electrical folder, then the Generic folder, and finally expand the Systems folder. Select the folder labeled Ladder, and the contents of that folder are displayed in the preview pane to the right. Select the Quick Takeoff button on the utility bar. The Quick Takeoff window appears in the primary pane. The Quick Takeoff can display a list view or a graphical view of the job items. From the pull-down menus, select Window, Cascade. Observe how all three windows are displayed in the primary pane. From the pull-down menus, select Window, Tile Vertically. The three windows are rearranged within the primary pane. The order in which these three windows appear depends upon the order in which they have been viewed. Each window is identified in the window headers. Although the order in which they appear is not important for this exercise, from left to right you should see Quick Takeoff, Item Folders, and then Contents. Locate the Job Contents window. It's identified by the label Contents in the window header. Maximize the Job Contents window by selecting the Maximize Window button in the top right corner of the window or by double-clicking the header of this window. The view pane shows only the Job Contents window. Switch to the Quick Takeoff window by selecting Quick Takeoff on the utility bar. With the Quick Takeoff window active, the footer of the program window displays additional information. The footer now contains the software prompt area, additional status indicators, and commands for the Quick Takeoff window. At the far left of the footer is the software prompt. The software displays messages in this location. At the far right are status indicators and buttons for placing items, redrawing the display, and viewing parts. Click on the File pull-down menu to expand the submenu. Some of these commands are also located on the utility bar and may be more easily accessed on that toolbar. This first group of commands creates, opens, saves, and closes jobs. Save job as enables saving a job file in a different location and or with a different name. The printer setup submenu includes commands to set up default printers for the various types of reports. The print layout submenu enables creation and selection of item reports, ancillary reports, worksheets, and nesting reports. Print preview and print open the process print tasks window where one or more reports may be selected for printing. Click on the Utilities pull-down menu to expand the submenu. Many of these commands are more easily accessed from the utility bar. The first three settings toggle the display of the Job Contents window, the Quick Takeoff window, and the Item Folders window. These act the same as the buttons on the utility bar. The Process submenu enables creation and selection of processes in the software. Processes are similar to macros in that one or more individual commands can be run as one single operation. This command can also be accessed from the utility bar. The manual and automatic nesting commands also appear on the utility bar. Nesting is the process of developing and efficiently placing flat patterns on a sheet of material with minimal waste. View and Write NC enable viewing of saved numerical control files and saving of NC files. When a job has been nested, it is then necessary to create the NC data for the nested sheets. This code tells the cutting machine what and how to cut. The actual NC data created is dependent upon which machine is being used and the settings of the installed machine within the software. The decoiler output command writes NC files to a decoiler unit. Select the Cloud pull-down menu. Autodesk 360 Cloud Nesting Services optimize the use of materials in your fabrication process. The Cloud Nesting command enables uploading of the job for nesting services. The Check Status command reports the status of your cloud nesting jobs. Click on the View pull-down menu to display the submenu choices. The commands listed on this pull-down menu change based upon the currently selected or active window in the primary view pane. The choices shown are active for the Job Contents window. The first three groups of settings control the list display within the current window. Icon sizes and arrangement may be controlled or set to Auto Arrange. The Arrange Icons flyout submenu sorts the list view by type. The toolbar's flyout submenu lists the job item content toolbar. This setting displays or hides the sections toolbar below the tabs and above the list view. The Refresh command redraws the program display window. Customize enables customization of the columns displayed in the job contents window. Click the Window pull-down menu. This submenu offers choices for arranging and displaying the various windows displayed in the primary pane. The Scripting command opens the script editor. It is used for creating, debugging, and saving scripts. Scripting is a built-in application programming interface for accessing and modifying object data programmatically. Scripts enable you to read and write object data on multiple objects, run tests, and interface with the user results of the script. Below the scripting command is a dynamic listing of all windows currently activated in the software. They may or may not be currently visible. Selecting one of these causes that window to be displayed in the primary view pane. Select the Help menu to display the submenu choices. The Content command opens the web-based help system for the Autodesk fabrication products. The keyboard shortcut to the help system is the question mark. Download Content opens the Content Solutions window, which links to the Autodesk Content Download Center. Most, if not all, of the content available from this site are bought-out items that are not fabricated. Send Support Files creates a compressed folder of your current job and the supporting database to send to product support. About displays information about this software, including version, serial number, and more. Click on Send Support Files. The Send Support Files window appears. Your source for product support may request that you send your job file for diagnostic purposes. The support technician guides you through this process and explains which options to select in this window. Click Cancel to close this window. Select Help About. The About window appears. Information about the software is listed in the pane. Your product support technician may request information such as the version number or the build number. This pane also displays the current configuration paths for database, item folders, reports, and more. This is a quick way to check which files are shared on the network. The Product Information button opens a window from which you can borrow a network license. Close this window by clicking on the red X in the upper right corner of the window. The utility bar resembles the ribbon used within other Autodesk products. Many of the buttons are commands that can be found on the pull-down menus or in right-click menus, but they are more quickly accessed from the utility bar. Click the first button to open the Browse for Jobs window. This browser only shows defined project folders on your computer, network, or in your Autodesk 360 cloud storage. It also shows recent jobs that you have worked on. The left pane is a tree list view of your project folders. Along the top of this pane are buttons to create, rename, and delete project folders. The right pane lists job files. Along the top of this pane are buttons to create, rename, duplicate, and delete jobs and archive jobs. Other buttons change the list display style and customize the list view. At the bottom of the window is a setting to show this browser every time the program starts. This browser window is also accessed from the Fabrication CamDuct start screen. Click Cancel to close this window. The Save Job button is inactive for new, empty jobs. Select the Close Job button. It closes the current job and asks if you want to save the job. Choose Cancel to return to the job. Click the Job Information button. The window displays information previously entered for this job as well as the current costing for the items in the job. The Summary tab provides a quick overview of project quantities, costs, and manufacturing time. Select the General tab. This displays the project path and information about the job. This information can also be entered when creating the job using the New Job Wizard. Some of this data can be linked to title blocks in spool drawings and in reports. Select the Project tab. Here you can choose to allow only certain service specifications to be used for this job. Choose the Company tab. Fabrication CamDuct enables creation of a company address book for the various entities involved in a project. Each entity can be entered here and saved in an address book. Select the Customer tab. Here you can enter, save, and recall customer information from an address book. Select the Shipping tab. As with the previous tabs, job sites or other shipping destinations can be entered, saved, and recalled. Click Cancel to close this window. The next three buttons on the utility bar display the Job Contents window, the Item Folders window, and the Quick Takeoff window in the Primary View pane. Click the Setup Processes button. The Processes window appears. Processes can be created, modified, or deleted from this window. Click Cancel to close this window. Notice the small triangle at the bottom right corner of the Setup Processes button. This is a flyout menu for quick access to predefined processes. Because there is no saved processes, this flyout menu does not display. Click the Automatic Nesting button. This tabbed window contains settings for the nesting commands. The settings shown are also accessible from the database editor. Click Cancel to close this window. Manual nesting is an advanced topic and is not included in this course. Select the Right NC button. Settings for generating the NC code for the machines are accessible from this window. Click Cancel to exit this window. Select the Database button to edit the database. The database contains most of the configuration settings for the software and the job. Click Cancel to close this window. Right-click anywhere on the utility bar and the Customize option is displayed. This is a shortcut to the database settings that modify the utility bar. Select Customize and the database window appears with the appropriate configuration settings for the utility bar displayed. At the top of this window are three settings which control the appearance of the utility bar. All three are enabled by default. Show the utility bar toggles the visibility of the utility bar. Use large icons toggles the use of small or large icons on the utility bar. Display text toggles the visibility of text labels on the utility bar. If show the utility bar is disabled, the utility bar along with the database button disappears. Disable the use large icon setting. The icons within the Show Buttons panes below are instantly resized. Click OK to save this change and close the database window. The utility bar changes to small icons. Right-click on the utility bar and select Customize. The database window appears. Enable Use Large Icons and disable Display Text. Click OK to see the effects on the utility bar. Right-click on the utility bar again and select Customize. The database window appears. Select the Restore Defaults button and click OK to save the changes. The utility bar reverts to the default appearance. If the utility bar disappears, it can be restored from within the database window, but the database button is on the utility bar. You must access the database window using a pull-down menu. To see how to recover the utility bar, drag the utility bar down into the primary pane so that it no longer docks along the top of the program window. Close the utility bar by clicking the red X at the top right of the utility bar. To restore the visibility of the utility bar, select the File pull-down menu and choose Setup, Database. The database window appears. Select the Configuration button at the top of the database window. In the left navigation pane, select Local Settings, Utility Bar. Enable the Show the Utility Bar setting. Selecting the Restore Defaults button at the lower right corner of this window also restores the utility bar visibility and resets all customizations to the defaults. Click OK to save this change and close this window. The utility bar appears where it was last displayed in the primary view pane. Drag the utility bar back to its original location and dock it just below the pull-down menus. There is no reset command to restore the utility bar to its default position. The Job Contents window should be visible within the primary pane. If it is not, select the Job Contents button on the utility bar or use the Windows pull-down menu to display it. The Job Contents window has a tabbed interface. The Items tab is a tabular list of all items in the job. The column widths may be manually adjusted or set to auto size. Clicking on a column header sorts the list in ascending or descending order. Click the column header named Item Number. Notice that the list is sorted in reverse or descending order. Click the same header again and the list resorts in ascending order. Hover the cursor over the header between the Item Number column and the Name column. The cursor changes to a double arrow. Click and drag the column divider to the left or right to resize the column width. The right-click shortcut menu within the Items pane offers different choices depending upon whether or not an item or multiple items are selected. Right-click in the Items pane below the list of items so that no items are highlighted. The right-click shortcut menu appears. This menu offers choices that affect all items in the job. Select Organize and the Item Organizer window appears. This window enables setting the nesting priorities for items in the job. Items can be manually assigned to groups. The items within each group are nested together. For example, all round end caps could be assigned to the same group and then nested together. Click Close to exit this window. Right-click below the listed items to display the shortcut menu again. Choose Locate. the Enter Filter window appears. This feature searches through the items in a job to find those which meet the search criteria. Click within the field at the top of the window and a drop-down menu of search criteria appears. Select Item Area and that criterion appears in the filter field. A drop-down menu appears with various operators listed. Pick the greater than symbol. That operator appears in the filter field. You must now enter a value to establish the minimum threshold for the search results. Enter 8 in the filter field. Click OK to close this window. The items in this job which have areas greater than 8 are highlighted. The area is the total surface area in square feet of material required to manufacture each of these items. Selecting anything clears the selection set, but the filter remains available for reuse with the Locate command. Right-click below the items and choose Locate again. Select the saved filter. At the bottom of the window are two options which may affect the filter result. Enabling Isolate Selected Objects causes all items in the job which do not meet this filter criterion to disappear from the items list view. Hide XRefs causes the items in any attached external reference files to be hidden. Enable Isolate Selected Objects and click OK to close the window. Only the items which meet the filter criteria are displayed. All other items in the job are hidden. The hidden items have not been removed from the job. They are merely invisible. This feature is helpful when working with only a few items in a large job. The isolation state of objects is saved with the job. When the job is later opened, the same objects remain visible or invisible. This can inadvertently cause confusion by making a job appear incomplete. The isolation state of items in a job also affects Fabrication CAD MEP and Fabrication EstMEP. Items which are hidden in Fabrication CamDuct are also invisible in the other Autodesk Fabrication products. It is a best practice to unhide all items when closing a job. Right-click below the items to, once again, display the shortcut menu. Choose Unhide All. All of the hidden items in the job are displayed and are highlighted. Right-click below the items to display the shortcut menu. Hover the cursor over View to display the flyout submenu. These choices modify the view type in the Items view pane. The default style, Details, is preferred. Hover the cursor over the Arrange Icons menu choice to display the flyout submenu. These choices sort the items list by the selected method. Clicking on the header for each column achieves the same result, and the list is sorted in ascending or descending order. The lineup icons and auto arrange choices also control the display of items in this pane. Deselect All clears the current selection set. Invert Selection reverses the selection set. Select All highlights all items in the job. Refresh forces a redraw of the list view. This can clear display anomalies and verify that all listed items' properties are updated. The information displayed in the Items List view pane can be modified to suit your needs. Select Customize. The Job Contents window appears. A tree list view of item details which may be displayed is shown on the left pane. The currently selected item details are shown in the right pane. Item details are also called item properties. Above the left pane is a search filter text field for quickly finding item details. The left and right arrow button move item details from one side to the other. The up and down arrow button change the display order in the items view pane. The topmost item detail in the right pane is the leftmost column in the items view pane. Type CID into the search field above the left pane. The long list of item details is shortened to just one item detail that matches the search criteria. Highlight the single item in the left pane and click the right arrow button to copy it to the left pane. Notice that it inserted above the highlighted item detail in the right pane. Using the down arrow button, move this new item detail down to be the last one listed in the right pane. Click OK to save this modified list layout. The CID column appears at the far right of the header. Right-click on the header again and select Customize. Highlight the CID item detail in the right pane and click the Edit Object Properties button on the right side of the window. This button is located between the up and down arrow buttons. The name that displays in the header can be changed if desired. Change it to Custom ID. Change the Justify setting to left and click OK to close this window with the new justification setting. Select OK to save these changes and close the Job Contents window. The rightmost column displays the changes. Right-click the list header and choose Customize again. With the CID item detail highlighted in the right pane, click the left arrow button to remove this object from the right pane. Click OK to save this change. The custom ID column disappears from the list view. You can also restore the job contents to the original settings by using the default button. This also resets the column widths. When an item is highlighted in the list view, the right-click shortcut menu offers many more choices. Highlight the first item in the list. This is a straight piece of duct. Right-click to display the shortcut menu. Hover the cursor over Background to display the flyout submenu. This submenu is identical to the right-click shortcut menu when no items are selected. Select Edit from the shortcut menu and the Takeoff window appears with the selected item. The Takeoff window enables modifications of the selected item. Sizes, materials, quantities, and other properties of this item can be changed for this item within this job. Because the selected item is already placed in the job, any changes to this item affect only this item and not the original source copy in the item folders. Make no changes to this item. Click the Cancel button at the bottom right of the window to return to the Job Contents window. With the same straight duct highlighted, right-click and choose Edit Developments on the shortcut menu. The Opus Drawing Editor window appears. Opus is a CAD program included in the Fabrication CamDuct program. It is used to modify existing flat patterns and to create new ones. Displayed in the drawing window is the flat pattern for the selected item. Make no changes and click Cancel in the lower right corner of the window. You're returned to the Job Contents window. Highlight the same straight and right-click. The Change Specifications feature enables assigning a different specification to the selected item or items. For example, ductwork assigned to a low pressure class could be changed to a higher pressure class, resulting in a thicker sheet metal material. The Swap Out feature enables users to change items for equivalent systems at the click of a button. For example, a supply air ductwork system made of sheet metal could be quickly and easily swapped out for a lower cost ductboard system. By performing the swap out, the items change place from one service to another and carry over specification entries. These include material thickness, standard straight lengths, flanges, seams, and more. Oversize Check performs a quick verification that all parts for the selected items, when nested, fit on the material sheet sizes. Automatically Nest performs a nesting operation to create flat patterns on sheets of material. Nest in Cloud uploads the selected items to the Autodesk Cloud Nesting Service. The Process submenu displays a list of any pre-configured processes. This submenu may display nothing if no processes have been saved. The Execute Script command enables browsing for saved scripts to be run. The next two menu choices preview and print pre-configured labels, worksheets, and reports for the selected items. The final choice on this shortcut menu is the Properties command. Select this command and the Item Properties window appears. Item properties are common to all items and are used by and visible within all of the Autodesk Fabrication products. Some of the tabs and settings are applicable to certain products. For example, the Costing tab contains information mostly relevant to Fabrication SDMEP. The default view is of the Item tab. It contains basic information about the selected item. The item number is sequentially assigned as items are added to the job. Quantity is typically assigned when the item is added to the job, but it can be changed in this field. The service is generally assigned when the item is added to the job, but it can be changed with this setting. The service type is also selected upon placement of the item and can be modified here. The assigned section is optional and is usually chosen when the item is added to the job. Select the Manufacturing tab. It contains information relevant to all of the Autodesk Fabrication products. The specification value can be automatically set by the service type if it is configured to do so. Otherwise, it is selected upon placement of the item and can be changed with this setting. The lock symbols to the right of each setting enable these values to be locked to prevent changes. These values can be permanently locked by the item's creator. The insulation specification can also be automatically or manually selected. The choice of service and specification determines the type of material for this item, but it can be changed with this setting. The gauge or thickness of the material is usually determined automatically by the service and specification, but it can be modified with this setting. The double wall setting enables an inner lining to the duct. Enable this setting to display additional settings on this tab. The skin material setting and the thickness or gauge setting next to it select the type of inner liner for double wall ducts. The insulation setting determines if insulation is to be applied to the duct and, if so, whether it is to be applied to the inside or outside of the duct. The adjacent setting sets the insulation type and thickness. The dim setting determines whether the duct size is the inside clear dimension or the outside dimension of the duct. Adding insulation to the inside of the duct and or adding a double wall changes the size of the clear air passage within the duct. The skin setting determines whether the liner is placed on the inside or outside of the duct. This also determines where the insulation is placed. The insulation facing setting establishes what treatment is to be applied to the exterior face of the insulation. For example, insulation that is not protected by a metal liner could have a foil wrap facing to protect it. Main facing, like insulation facing, specifies the treatment, if any, applied to the exposed surfaces of the ductwork. This could be paint, powder coating, or a fire retardant coating. The structure field offers choices of structural systems from which this item may be supported. This affects the fixings of the supports to the structure. These settings may be customized in the service specifications. The stiffeners and support settings, both types and quantities, are normally set automatically by the item specification. Select the Other tab. This tab displays settings for connections and seams. These settings are typically set when the item is created, but can be easily modified as required. Select the General tab. A BMP or JPG file can be associated with the item using the Change button. The associated image is only displayed on this tab to the left of the Change button. Selecting the Default button clears the setting. The Source Path and File Name settings point to the ITM file for the selected item. The CID setting is the custom identification number for this item. It is typically the same as the source pattern used to create this item, but it can be changed. The source pattern number is shown to the right of the CID value. The item description is entered when the item is created, but can be changed as needed. Alias is an additional descriptor value that can be displayed in a list view, in a report, or as annotation within the model. For example, an item named Fire Damper might have FD as its alias value. The type value is set by the item creator and is used to categorize items. Straight ducts are usually categorized as a straight, whereas a T connection would have a type value of fitting. Notes may be used to indicate special instructions for this item and are available from the drop-down menu for this field. Standards notes, such as urgent delivery, are maintained in the database. Click the Developments tab. A development is the flat pattern layout which is used to fabricate the item. A graphical representation of the flat pattern for each part of the item is displayed. The note above the graphic indicates that this is one part of one required to fabricate this item. Settings for the material type and gauge are shown beside the image. The blank size is the rectangular size of the material needed to produce this part. Nesting enables the user to set a preferred nesting method for this item. This overrides the nesting method chosen when performing an automatic nest. The graining angle is important when cutting pieces from materials with noticeable grain. This is commonly used when stainless steel ductwork is to be exposed to view. Nesting priority can be set on an item-by-item basis to group certain parts together. The next and previous buttons are used to view all of the individual parts of the item. In this case, the straight duct piece has only one part. Click Cancel to close the Item Properties window. Select one of the items named Transition. Right-click and choose Properties. The Item Properties window appears. Select the Developments tab. Notice the shape of this part. The note above the graphic indicates that this is one of four parts required to fabricate this transition. Click the Next button and observe the change. The values for most settings do not change, but the blank size does change to fit each individual part. Click Next and Previous to cycle through the four parts. Click Cancel to close the Item Properties window. Select all of the items in this job. You can do this using one of several methods, but pressing Ctrl plus A may be the quickest. Right-click to display the shortcut menu. Although this menu is similar to the single item right-click shortcut menu, there are a few differences. Multiple items may be saved as a single sub-assembly for reuse. Select the Properties command. The Multiple Items Properties window appears. The tab displays the number of items selected. When different types of items are selected, only certain common properties can be displayed and modified. Enable the Double Wall option and note the changes to this window. Select Cancel to close this window. Just below the tabs in the Job Contents window is the Sections toolbar. Sections are used to subdivide the model or job into layers associated with areas in the building. These can be entire floor levels or defined areas such as plant room, toilets, foyer, etc. Sections affect how the elevation of an item is reported. Sections also control the length of hanger rods by establishing the soffit elevation or the elevation of the structure above. Select the drop-down menu to the right of the Sections toolbar pull-down. The sections defined in the database are listed in groups. The default is All Sections, which should be left as the selected choice. To the left of this drop-down menu is the Section link. Click this link. This opens the database editor for creating, modifying, and deleting sections. Select Cancel to close this window. To the right of the Sections pull-down menu is the New Section button. Select this button. This dialog enables quick creation of a new section without opening the database. Click Cancel to close this dialog. The last button opens the Opus drawing program. Select this button to display the Opus interface. On the utility bar, select Job Contents to return to that window. Hide the Sections toolbar by selecting View, Toolbars, Job Item Contents. You won't need to access or use sections for this exercise. Select the Nests tab in the Job Contents window. The items in this job have already been converted to flat patterns and nested on sheets. The Nests view shows graphical representation of sheets of material, in this case galvanized sheet metal, with the parts needed to fabricate the items in this job. Each of the nested sheets is labeled Untitled. Fabrication CamDuct automatically renames these sheets once NC code has been written for each sheet. Double-click on the first sheet in the Nests view. The Manual Nest window appears for the selected sheet. This window enables you to manually adjust the nesting of the parts on this sheet of material. Manual nesting is an advanced topic. Select the Job Contents button on the utility bar to return to the Nests view. With no sheet selected, right-click to display the shortcut menu. This shortcut menu is almost identical to that within the Items tab. Press Escape to clear the shortcut menu. Select the first nested sheet and right-click to display the shortcut menu. The Edit command is the same as double-clicking the nested sheet. It opens the manual nesting window. View NC enables viewing the machine code written for this nested sheet. The NC code for this sheet has not been written yet, and the sheet is labeled Untitled. Once the NC code has been created, this flyout menu displays the file. The Select Machine command assigns a specific machine to cut these parts. This overrides the automatic nesting settings. Write NC is the same as the button on the utility bar. This produces an NC code file. If an NC code file exists, it can be deleted using the Delete NC command. The Print and Print Preview commands enable creation of reports for the selected sheet or sheets. Duplicate Nests replicates the selected nested sheets. The DXF export command creates a DXF file of the nested sheet for use with external CAD or CAM systems. The Export Data command starts the Export Data Wizard. Specific information about the selected nested sheets can be exported to TXT or CSV files for use with other software programs. Empty clears all nested parts from the selected sheet or sheets. The Delete command removes the selected sheets. Select the Item Folders button on the utility bar. This window provides a tree list view of the items in the currently selected configuration in the left pane with preview images of the items in the right pane. These are items which can be placed or inserted into the job. Expand the folder structure to expand Imperial Content, HVAC, Generic, Systems, and select Ductboard. The items within this folder appear in the preview pane. Notice that the right pane displays a large icon view of the items rather than a list or details view. This particular folder was last set to a large icon view display. Right-click in the right pane and select View from the shortcut menu. Select Details. The view changes for this subfolder. Use the Display Type buttons above the preview pane to change the view back to large icons. The divider bar between the left and right panes can be moved left or right to resize the panes. Hover the cursor over the divider bar until the cursor changes to a double arrow. Click and drag the divider bar left or right to resize the panes. Locate the Drop Cheek Junction item in the preview pane. Right-click on this item and choose Properties in the shortcut menu. The Item Properties window appears with information about this particular item. The item properties for an item include detailed fabrication and costing information. Close the window by clicking Cancel. Select the View pull-down menu and hover the cursor over Toolbars to display the Flyout submenu. The Toolbar's Flyout submenu choices are specific to the Item Folders window. The Item Folders toolbar is located immediately above the Item Preview pane. Buttons on this toolbar perform basic file functions such as Delete, Copy, and Paste. They also change the display view from Small Icon to Large Icon to Detail. The last button opens the Opus Drawing program. The Item Search toolbar appears immediately above the Item Folders tree list view. It enables searching for items in the database. Press Escape twice to clear the pull-down menus. Locate the Item Search toolbar above the left pane. The drop-down menu in the toolbar enables searching on various attributes such as the Item Description or CID. Leave the choice set to Description. In the Item Search toolbar, type asterisk cheek asterisk into the Search Criteria field. The asterisks before and after the search term enable any item with a description containing cheek to be included in the search results. Entering cheek without the asterisks limits search results to items with the description of cheek without any characters before or after. As a best practice, include asterisks before and or after the desired search term. Select the arrow button at the right of the search field to display the search results. The search tool scans down the tree list view and highlights each item that meets the search criteria. It displays only one folder of data at a time. Pressing the arrow button repeatedly cycles through the entire database, individually highlighting each item which meets the search criteria. Select Quick Takeoff on the utility bar. The Quick Takeoff window appears. The main view pane of the Quick Takeoff window includes a tabbed interface for graphical views and non-graphical list views of the job. Select the Items tab if it is not already selected. The Items list view is the same as the Job Contents window. The list can be sorted and the columns customized just like the Job Contents window. The right-click shortcut menus in the Items tab are the same as in the Job Contents window. Along the left side of the window is the Service palette. It is a tabbed interface with each tab containing different items that can be inserted or placed into the model. Each item contains detailed information for pricing and fabrication purposes. At the top of the Service palette is a drop-down menu for choosing the current service. Select the Service drop-down menu and expand the ADSK Plumbing Domestic Service Group. Select the Cold Water Service. The Service palette changes to display items in the Cold Water Service. Restore the service to ADSK HVAC Supply Air. To the left of the Service drop-down menu is the Service link. Click this link to open the Setup Services window. Services can be created, modified, and deleted in this window. Make no changes and click Cancel to close the window. The service palette can be stretched, moved, and docked. Experiment with stretching the service palette. Notice that the icons, also known as service buttons, resize and rearrange according to the width of the window. Right-click on the service palette below the service buttons. A shortcut menu appears. There are choices to set the service button sizes or to have them automatically sized based upon the width of the service palette. The service palette contents can be organized into tabs. Browse the service palette contents by selecting various tabs. The contents of each service palette differ depending upon the system or trade that it displays. The service palette window can also be closed. If it is unintentionally closed, it can be turned back on with the View Use Services command on the pull-down menu. Click on the 3D Viewer tab. You may think of the 3D Viewer tab as a CAD system similar to the drawing window in AutoCAD. The 3D Viewer is common to both Fabrication CamDuct and Fabrication SDMEP. The 3D Viewer is not essential to the use of Fabrication CamDuct and is rarely used. The 3D Viewer is not covered in this course. Review the Fabrication SDMEP Fundamentals course to learn about the 3D Viewer. Whenever an item is edited or selected for placement into the job, it appears in the Takeoff window. Click the Job Contents button on the utility bar. Select the Items tab if it is not already selected. The list of items in this job is displayed. Make sure the list is sorted in ascending order by item number. Select item number 1 in the list. This is a straight duct. Right-click and choose Edit. The Takeoff window appears with this item displayed. The 4 viewports on the left side of the window provide different views of the item. Each viewport's view and visual display style can be changed to suit your needs. Within each viewport are drop-down menus for view and visual display style. Selecting within a viewport activates that viewport. The toolbar docked along the left side of the Takeoff window affects the selected viewport. In the upper right corner of each viewport is a Viewport Maximize button. Selecting this button expands the viewport to fill the window. Selecting it when the viewport is maximized returns the viewport to the tiled arrangement. Item properties are shown on the right side of the window. There are several tabs. Changes made to the item only affect the item that has been placed in this job. The last tab is the Help command for this item. Select this tab. This help page is for the source pattern used to create this item. At the bottom of the window are buttons to modify this item. The Hole button adds a hole to a selected face of the item. Remove deletes all holes in the item. Develop opens the Opus drawing window with this item's flat pattern displayed. The Redraw button causes the viewports to refresh with any changes made to the item properties. Cancel discards changes made to this item and closes the takeoff window. Accept saves the changes and exits the takeoff window. Click Cancel to close the takeoff window. The job contents window is displayed. Select Item Folders on the utility bar. Right-click on the circular T item and choose Edit. Alternatively, you can double-click on the item and it opens in the takeoff window. The takeoff window appears with this selected item from the database. Any changes made to this item modify the item in the database. Click Cancel to exit this window. Select the Close Job button on the utility bar. Fabrication CamDuct asks if you want to save the job. Click No. The software offers one final opportunity to save any changes made. Click Yes to discard the changes and exit the job.